As one of America's largest family-owned waste and recycling companies, Rumpke recycles more than 900 million pounds of glass, paper, aluminum, and other materials from throughout much of Ohio, Kentucky, Indiana, and West Virginia each year.
My family has been involved in recycling and managing the waste stream for generations.
By going to work with my dad as a very young child, working on the truck with him, going out with him, seeing the enjoyment that he got, it was something that I wanted to be part of.
We know we're in a tough business. We know that, you know, what we do isn't always pretty, but it's necessary, and we want to do the best job we can at handling those materials and really be a first-class operation.
Here at Rumpke Sanitary Landfill, we're permitted to take about 10,000 tons of solid waste a day. We're currently taking about 6,000 tons a day. There's only so much waste that you can compact into an area that's developed for landfills. So it's very important that we continue to try to reduce the waste that comes into this location so we can make it last longer and we can save that space for those materials where there just isn't a market yet.
In 1986, the Rumpke Sanitary Landfill near Cincinnati became one of the first landfills to recover methane and other natural gases generated underground by the decomposition of organic materials.
Behind us, we have our gas recovery plant. What's happening here is we have a series of pipes and wells that collect that gas. This plant separates the CO2 from the methane and puts the clean methane into the pipeline. Most landfills currently burn their gas off, so they collect it and vent it off and burn it so that it's not going into the atmosphere. Here we're capturing that gas and using that gas for beneficial use. There's enough gas produced from this landfill that we can heat 25,000 homes.
Rumpke also uses compressed natural gas from its landfill to power dozens of its trucks.
This is the largest landfill to natural gas project in the world.
In the fall of 2013, Rumpke opened a state-of-the-art $32 million MRF, short for Material Recovery Facility, in St. Bernard, Ohio, near Cincinnati.
For every 10,000 tons of waste that goes to a landfill, you create one job. For every 10,000 tons you can recycle, you create between 8 to 10 jobs. And that multiplies itself. You know, we have over 100 employees here in Cincinnati based on recycling materials that were at one time going to the waste stream. What a great story.
55 tons of recyclable materials are processed at the MRF every hour. From here, it's sorted into separate streams by a combination of people and technology, using a complex system of chutes and conveyors. Sorters are located at various stations throughout the process, each pulling out stuff that either doesn't belong or could gum up the works. Some technology is designed to shake and sift apart specific recyclables from the rest. Other machines, called disc screeners, send the stream of materials over spinning discs that propel larger items, like cardboard sheets, along the line, while allowing smaller items, such as plastics, steel, and aluminum cans, to fall through gaps between the discs, down chutes to other conveyor belts. Another machine is the angled sorter, a wide conveyor tipped at an angle and inclined at a sharp upward angle so that three-dimensional items, like water bottles, roll off onto a conveyor below while newspapers continue on to their destination. Other technologies at work in the MRF are an overhead magnet that attracts the metal cans and an eddy current used to separate aluminum cans. The eddy current uses rare earth magnets to repel the aluminum cans, causing them to jump several feet forward while other material falls onto a separate conveyor. Rumpke uses optical scanners to detect newspaper, cartons, plastic water, and 2-liter bottles, along with other plastic containers like milk jugs and laundry detergent bottles. The scanners project a beam of infrared light onto a fast-moving conveyor belt and determine what kind of material is passing by. If the item is something the scanner is set to identify, it instantly sends a message to a computer, triggering a quick blast of air to divert the item to another conveyor. Once the recyclables have been separated, they're pressed into bales that can weigh anywhere from 800 pounds for aluminum cans to well over a ton for paper. Bales are loaded onto trucks or railroad cars and shipped to factories to be made into something new. Rumpke ships bales of newspaper, for example, to such faraway destinations as China and India.
The great thing about the U.S. is we generate very good quality material, and the rest of the world wants it.
glass makes up 15 to 20% of what Rumpke collects from its residential customers.
We now, in Cincinnati and Columbus, send our broken mixed glass to our state-of-the-art glass recovery facility in Dayton, Ohio.
There, it's ground into particles the size of a grain of sand and used to manufacture fiberglass insulation. Optical scanners are also used to sort larger pieces of glass according to color, whether it's clear or amber, to be made into new bottles. Either way, glass can be recycled over and over again. So that's how recycling happens at Rumpke. From the company's earliest days back in the 1930s, Rumpke has always looked for ways to find value in all the stuff you throw away, as well as ways to manage and control the river of garbage, to put less of it in the ground and more of it back to good use.
Every year, the recycling rates go up and the trash rates come down. I think there will come a day where recycling and waste become similar, and even one day that we actually maybe recycling more than we throw away.